I don't use the fear of hell. I am using it as the word of God says, that if you do not obey Him, you go to hell. Where is the fear of hell there that I am using to gain financial favors? If I am gaining financial favors, I will not tell you the truth about hell.
A comment in YouTube po, Pastor, from Alex Gardose. He said, Kibuloy claims things that are not true. He's supposed to sow love, peace, and forgiveness, but he spreads divisiveness, hate, arrogance, and you ask that yourself directly to his false face, and do yourself a favor reading between his lines. In the Bible, it talks about charlatans, people with glib tongues, using fear of hell to gain financial favors. They are predators. Do not trap yourself to one. It is your choice. Do not be blinded.
Alex Gardose, you said that I claim that there are things I claim that are not true. You did not say what are those claims. You said you're supposed to show love, peace, and forgiveness, but it spreads divisiveness, hate, arrogance. You don't know what love is. The true love is obedience to the words of the Almighty Father.
Amen.
You don't know what true peace is. There can only be true peace with God when you are obedient to His word. And then you said forgiveness. You can only be forgiven if you repent of your serpent seed and say to the Father, from now on, not my will, but your will be done. And I am preaching all of this.
Amen.
So, you are the ones that are saying things that are not true about me.
True.
You are the one. Okay? And then you said, I spread divisiveness. Divisiveness in what? Not divisiveness with those who follow the will of the Father. Maybe divisiveness, you mean to say, I divide the sheep from the goats. That's true. It is biblical, Matthew 13. If you mean divisiveness, I divide the tares from the wheat. So I pull up the tares, throw them into the fire, and then let the wheat grow. If you mean by divisiveness, it is the division between the good and evil. It's like Matthew 13, the kingdom is like unto a net, which caught different kinds of fishes. When they drew to shore, they divided the good and the bad. You see that? Which, when it was full, blow it. They drew to shore and sat down and gathered the good into the vessels, but cast the bad away. If you mean by divisiveness by that, there is really division in the scriptures. You divide the bad from the good. So the bad goes away. In heaven it happens. Satan, Lucifer, the devil was divided from the good angels. If you mean by hate, I have hate, but I only hate the evil that Satan is doing in making people disobey God.
Amen.
That is the kind of hate I am proposing. And I have that kind of hate. Hate Satan, Lucifer, the devil, and his serpent seed of teaching people how to disobey the will of God. What about your kind of hate? What is it? You say arrogance? Arrogance to me means even if you speak softly, act softly, but you are disobedient to the words of God, you are the most arrogant in the sight of the Father. To me, arrogance is not doing the Father's will, although you talk softly. To me, humility is obedience to the words of the Almighty Father, although I speak boldly.
Amen.
As a lion. That is how passionate I am when talking about the Father's will. And then you said, ask that yourself directly to his false face. What is false about my face? I don't have plastic surgery. I did not do anything with my face. My face is real.
Amen.
Whatever you see in this face is what you get.
Amen.
When I say obedience to the will of the Father, I obey the will of the Father. Yes. That is the passion of my life. Yes. And that is why I am teaching people. Maybe you look at your face and maybe you have the one that has a false face. And you say, do yourself a favor, reading between his lines. What are you reading between my lines? What are you reading between my lines? Condemning the serpents? Condemning the traitors against the will of the Father? Is reading between the lines saying that Lucifer, the devil, is a traitor to the kingdom of God and to the throne of righteousness in heaven? Is that what you mean by reading in between the lines? That I am good, that I am obedient, that I am committed, that I am dedicated and loyal to do the Father's will?
Amen.
There is no reading between the lines in my message.
Yes.
They are all clear.
Amen.
Very clear. You said, in the Bible, it talks about charlatans. Yes. Oh, who are the charlatans to me? Those that changes the word of God. The one from the Holy One, you change it to the Holy Tree, they are charlatans. Those that are very close to God with their lips, but their hearts are far away from Him because they are disobedient, they are the charlatans. Who are the charlatans to me? Those that changes the words of God. Those that do miracles. Those that cast out devils. Those that do prophecy, but they are disobedient to the words of God. They are the charlatans.
Amen.
Religious people have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. And they formulate their own righteousness like the Holy Tree. And then obey it and hold on to it. And they depart from obedience to the will of the Father. They are the charlatans to be. You said people with glib tongues. Those people with glib tongues are the deceivers. If you say there is no Holy One, there is only Holy Three, you are a glib tongue. You are a serpent with a divided tongue. Those are the glib tongue to me. If you preach the Word of God eloquently, but you are disobedient and you don't obey it, and you are changing the Word of God, you are the glib tongue to me. Using fear of hell to gain financial favors. You are the ones doing that.
Yes.
You know, using the fear of hell. I don't use the fear of hell. I am using it as the word of God says, that if you do not obey Him, you go to hell.
Yes.
Where is the fear of hell there that I am using to gain financial favors? If I am gaining financial favors, I will not tell you the truth about hell. Like those charlatans who came from the kingdom. They said, there is no more hell, there is no heaven, there is no God. Just so they can be popular outside and they can be neutral and so they can gain favor and money. Me, when I tell you that if you don't repent, you go to hell, where's the financial favor there? Many people will hate me for that because many people like you are carnal. But just because you are carnal and you have money and I want to please you, did I change the word of God? Did I adulterate the word of God? Did I make the word of God easy for you? No, I talk and taught it like it was taught 2,000 years ago. Where is financial favor there? I will not get rich in telling people if you don't repent, you go to hell. I don't get rich by that. I don't get rich by people telling them, you know, you have to repent. You have to obey the Father's will. You have to go through the fire. I don't get rich by doing that. I did not get rich obeying the Father's will in Tamayong when I ate bananas for 5 years just because I want to obey His will. So you are judging me incorrectly. You said they are predators. Who are the predators? Those that changes the word of God. Those who were used by Satan, Lucifer, the devil, to dilute the word of God from the Holy One to the Holy Three. And then you say the biots will go to heaven, 1 Corinthians 6:9, and the lesbians will go to hell. 1 Corinthians 6:9, Romans 1:27, you are saying that you are a predator. Predators are those who take away obedience from the sheepfold, those who deceive the flock of God by making them disobedient against the will of God. Those are the predators. You said, do not trap yourself to one. You are now being trapped to one. You are in the trap of Satan, Lucifer, the devil. I am here to save you. Oh, you said, it is your choice. What is your choice? Obedience or disobedience? Repentance or no repentance? Your choice. And he said, do not be blinded. Do not be blinded by yourself. Open your eyes to the truth of obedience to the will of the Father is the only one that can save us. Did you mention Matthew 7:21? No, you did not, because you are blinded. What does Matthew 7:21 says? Not all that say to me, Lord, Lord, and you are one of them, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father who is in heaven. Are you doing his will? I'll ask you one question. Do you believe in the Holy One or Holy Three? I know your answer. You are Holy Three. You are blinded. Wake up. I am here for the enlightenment of the world.